Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Rahul Singh, so I'll just start with my introduction. So basically, I'm a digital marketing practitioner, a growth marketer who specializes in content marketing, social media marketing, and have more than 15 years of experience. Have worked with various corporates, primarily into the banking sector, over managing their marketing domains. And last 5 years, I have been running a digital agency by the name of Digital Niti, wherein we help businesses to grow their business through digital marketing. So today, our talk would be how do you do growth marketing for startups? So how many of you are in the audience are running a startup? Anybody who runs a startup out here? Two people. So three, four. So for a startup, the biggest challenge is having limited resource. And with that limited resource, how do you grow your business? I think people who have their own startup, they know they have to grow their business, but with a very limited resource. So how do they grow? So there is a term called growth marketing. So what is basically growth marketing? Growth marketing is intelligent data-driven marketing with the aim of acquiring more customers. So basically, if you are doing growth marketing, your whole idea is to acquire more customers by following a data-driven approach, which is iterative in a way, wherein a process which we can repeat day in, day out. So that is basically growth marketing, wherein how do you acquire more customers who translate into more revenue and gives you retention and revenue. So that is what is meant by growth marketing. So what is the difference between a growth marketing and a digital marketing, and how does both differ? So basically, a growth marketer thinks about the entire funnel. Like people who are in marketing, they would understand. There is a concept called funnel, wherein you acquire more customers, and they in turn gives you revenue, and which in turn gives you profit. So the growth marketing, if somebody is doing growth marketing, he has to think about the entire funnel, not only about acquiring more customers, but also about how do you retain customers, and how do you ensure that customers become an evangelist, wherein they start recommending your product to different people and different customers. Whereas a traditional marketer only thinks about top of the funnel. So in traditional marketing, what happens? You only think about how do you acquire more customers. But your approach is not that once you have acquired customer, how does that customer gives you revenue, or how does that customer becomes a loyal fan. So that is a basic difference between a growth marketer as well as a traditional marketer. So why growth marketing is very necessary? See, in today's environment, it has become too crowded. If you look at any businesses, you will have n number of competitors in your business. So you have to do something different in which you stand out among the competitors. So in order to break the noise, it has become increasingly important to have a marketing strategy which is creative, iterative, and compelling, so that people start recommending your products. A strategy which not only helps you in customer acquisition, but is one of the breeding ground for virality. So if you want to grow your business, and if you want to stand out among the noise, so the only strategy that you can use is growth marketing, which becomes iterative in process, and which is creative, and which helps you in virality. So in growth marketing, we have something called growth hacking funnel. Like, how do you do growth marketing? So there is a terminology which has been coined by a famous venture capitalist called David McClure, who says there is something called pirate funnel or R funnel. So what does a pirate funnel means, and how does it look like? So pirate funnel starts with awareness. So if you have a product, your first step would be to make people aware about your product. Your second step would be, how do you ensure you acquire customer for your product or services? And your third step would be, how do you activate those customers? So once you have acquired your customers, whether those customers are buying from you or not. So typically, if you are doing marketing, your traditional marketer stops at these three funnels: awareness, acquisition, and activation. Whereas a growth marketer, if you are doing growth marketing, you go a step ahead and you think about how do you retain your customers, how do you generate revenue out of those customers, and how do you ensure those customers which you have which you have bought in, they pass on reference to you. So these are the three additional steps which the growth marketers think about. So in awareness stage, what do you think? How many people you want to reach? How many people you have reached? In the second step, how many people are visiting your website? If I'm thinking about from the website perspective, how you have built up a website and how many people are reaching your website? And the third step would be activation. Like once a customer is on your website, what is the action that you want that customer to take on your website? And if you are a growth marketer, you go a step ahead and you think, how many people are coming back and buying up from you from the second time, third time, and n number of time, and how many people have started paying? And the last step would be how many people are referring your product and services to the different people. So if you are a growth marketer, you have to look at these three funnel additionally apart from the first three, your retention, revenue, and referral. So once you have acquired your customer, once you have made activation of your customers, how do you ensure you retain your customer, you generate revenue out of your customers, and how do you ensure you get referral from your customers? So I will share with you three examples of growth marketing which famous companies did to create a virality about their product. You might have heard of Dropbox. How many of you don't know about Dropbox? Kinko nahi pata Dropbox kya hai? Most of the people knows about Dropbox. So Dropbox is basically a cloud-based solution. So when Dropbox started their marketing, what they did, they started offering free spaces to people who invited their customers. So abhi aapko lagega common hai, but I'm talking about 2007-8. When Dropbox started, they were saying ki you invite your people to sign up with our product and we'll offer you additional space. Like they were giving 16 GB additional space. So without spending any money, they have an infrastructure in place, a cloud infrastructure. Without spending any money, they started acquiring more customers. So this is one example of growth marketing, wherein you are not spending money. Whatever resources you have, you are creating a virality among your customers and people are coming and buying from you. So Dropbox is one example which I wanted to share with you. Second was Airbnb. Kinko pata Airbnb kya hai? So most of the people know Airbnb. So when Airbnb started in San Francisco, if I'm not wrong, they had a big problem. Their biggest competitor was Craigslist. So Craigslist is like, India mein se Just Dial hai na, waise US mein there is a listing website called Craigslist. So log kya karte the, agar unko apna property rent mein dalna tha, if they wanted to put their property on rent, so they were going and making a listing on Craigslist. So what Airbnb did, unhone apne bande ko bola, you go and visit Airbnb, Craigslist website and see who all are posting their listing. So un customer ko they were approaching and saying, okay, we also have a similar platform, so wherein you can list your apartment or your flat for free of cost. So initially they started doing manual work. So what they did, they didn't do any promotion, they didn't do any marketing, just they started using a common sense and some growth hacking techniques wherein they spied up on their competitors and they started approaching their competitors. So initially they were doing manually, then they wrote codes and coding ke through, whosoever were getting listed in Craigslist was automatically getting listed on Airbnb. So initially what Airbnb did, they utilized this process to growth market their. Now the third example which I wanted to show you is of LinkedIn. So if you go to Google, if you wanted to search about somebody, like if you want to search about me, say Rahul Singh, you will see people generally write name of the person. So LinkedIn, what they did, LinkedIn studied the phenomena of the users. How does a users search on web? So they found people when they are searching for some individual profile are writing names. So what they did in their product, they started showing the public listing of their profile. Like if you have a profile on LinkedIn, you'll see if somebody searches your name, so your name comes on top. So unhone apna product ka backend aise develop kiya, so unka jo customer base hai, they started showing on the Google listing. So this was one strategy which LinkedIn used, wherein they growth hacked their product and they started creating virality about their product. So now if you are a startup, how do you ensure with a limited budget, you start creating virality, you start reaching more number of people? So the number one strategy, there are many, many things which you can do. So there are five things which I can suggest. One is network invitation. Like if you have seen, whenever you are signing up with Facebook, Google, you get a prompt wherein you are asked, okay, you also ask your people to sign up. So why this thing happens? So if you have a product which requires n number of users, so aap apne customer ko ye offer de sakte, you can give your offer to your customers, you invite people to come on our network. So this will create what? This will create more number of users for your product and customers. You just need to ensure whatever product you have a sign up option wherein he or she can invite people to come and use your product and services. So network invitation is one thing which you as a startup or you as a business can use to your advantage. You don't need to spend any money. You don't need to do n number of resources. You just need to have a prompt wherein you can ask people to sign up for your product or services. Second thing, if you are looking for growth marketing, which you can do is social sharing. Now, what do you mean by social sharing? Everybody here uses Facebook, Instagram. What do we share? We share, generally share those kind of things which we like. Apne ko jo pasand aata, we start sharing those things. So if you have a product and services, so you have to enable your product and services in such a way that it can be shared with different people. So if you have a website, you put in widgets of say Facebook, say Instagram, if somebody wants to share about a website, so it reaches to n number of people. So aapko apna product and services aisa banana hoga wherein it becomes very easy to share. So one example is social sharing. So you enable social sharing in your say website so that it reaches more number of people. The third example would be offering incentives. Like as I shared a Dropbox example, you have to incentivize your people. So if you are from service-based business, it becomes very easy. Because in service-based business, your input cost is limited. So if you are a coach or if you are giving some teaching classes, as my friend who was sharing the earlier slide. So agar aap koi class de rahe ho, you offer them 1:1 free class. So you don't need to spend more money. What you are doing, you are just providing an incentive to your customer to invite more number of people. So that is one strategy which you can use to invite more number of people and grow your business. Now fourth is my personal favorite, organic word of mouth. So the best marketing is organic marketing or word of mouth marketing. If somebody likes your product and services, he or she will definitely recommend it to your other people. So you have to ensure your product is very simple. Whatever is your product, unka messaging should be very simple. What problem they are solving. आपके सामने जो कस्टमर है, कस्टमर का प्रॉब्लम क्या सॉल्व हो रहा है, दैट्स इट. इफ यू आर सॉल्विंग द इफ यू आर मैसेजिंग एंड इज सच दैट योर प्रोडक्ट और सर्विसेज इज सॉल्विंग द नीड ऑफ द कस्टमर्स, योर कस्टमर विल स्टार्ट स्पीकिंग गुड अबाउट योर प्रोडक्ट. जैसे अपने मूवी देखने जाते हैं, आई विल गिव यू वन एग्जांपल, वी गो एंड वॉच मूवी, तो व्हाट वी जनरली डू, अपने को प्रोड्यूसर एक्टर पैसा नहीं देता कि ये जाकर बोलो मूवी अच्छा, व्हाट वी जनरली डू, वी कम एट होम एंड से नो ये मूवी बहुत अच्छा है, आप ले जाकर देखो. So same, you have to build your product and services in such a way that people start speaking about your product and service. And how do you ensure? The only way you can ensure is you have to build very simple products, easy to understand, wherein people can know what problem your product and services is solving. So this is one strategy which you can do. The last strategy is building a community around your product. Apne saath yahan pe WordCamp mein baithe hain. So now WordCamp is what? WordCamp is basically a community, an event driven by community. We have like-minded people shared in this room, speaking, talking, sharing about our experiences. So you as a business owner also need to build a community around your product. You don't need to sell anything. You just need to create awareness about your product. Ki wo product, how that product is helping your customers. You have to, if you are into service business, you have like, say WordPress. This WordCamp is all about how WordPress is helping people. So we have, say, different developers, we have marketing people, we have hosting companies. So all ecosystem are coming under one roof. So if you have a business, you also have to ensure that you build a community around your product. Once you build a community around your product, once people understand what is your product all about, how is it helping people, they will automatically come and buy product from you. They will automatically come and buy services from you. So you should start building communities. Communities are free of cost. Jaise Facebook mein group bana lo. You start, if you are a small type businessman, make a WhatsApp group. WhatsApp group mein you start sharing some tips of the day. If you are a coach, agar aapka koi product hai, you make a group and say ki how that product is helping people. So you might not get immediate results. You might not get people coming and buying product from you, coming and buying services from you. But what you can, what will it happen? People can come to know about your product and services. So that is one thing which you can do. So these are the five ways in which without spending money. So as I, in the opening remarks I said, growth marketing or growth hack is something in which you don't need to spend too much of money. So these are the five ways, again I will share the deck. So network invitation, social sharing, incentives, organic word of mouth, and building a community around your brand. These are the five ways which are proven, wherein you don't need to spend money. This is repetitive, like, and this is scalable. So it doesn't require you to spend money with limited resource. You can create a brand about your product. You can reach to more number of people. So that's it. That's what a short thing about how you can grow your startup if you are into want to do growth marketing. Now I'll be ready to take questions. Or aapke kuch questions hai around my thing I'm ready to take. Yes, it's similar to affiliate marketing. So affiliate marketing is basically what you have a services in place, aapka cost remain fixed. You don't need to put any extra input after costing to fix that. So you start offering incentives to your customers. So that's how you can build. Yes, sir. So why do you think people switch? If you are a startup, why do you think people switch?
For the money.
For the money. So as a startup, aapko ek vision aapke employees ko dikhani hogi. As in, if you are seeing, as you rightly said, startup mein ke aapke baad limited resource hota hai, so you cannot offer higher salary. So people keep hopping from one place to another space. So if you look at all the unicorns, jitne bhi unicorns abhi hai, one common strategy which they have used to retain employees are ESOPs. So you have to also start sharing your vision with them. Unko ye vision dikhana ki, dekho, aaj ho sakta apne chote hai, we are just starting off. For 5 years, 6 years, 10 years down the line, if I become big, so this is the percent of ownership which I'm willing to share with you. Aap unka base salary chota rakho and share some ownership with them. So that unko ye na lage ki chalo aaj mere ko kam salary mila and if I go to some other organization, they will offer me a bigger salary. So you look at any unicorns. One uniform strategy which they do to retain employees is offering ESOPs. So aap ESOP offer karo. Agar aapki structured utni organization agar nahi hai, so you start incentivizing people. You have small amount of say fixed salary agar choti organization. Base salary choti rakho, uska incentivize jyada rakho. You do this milestone and you achieve more. So that is one thing I can recommend, which is again a proven framework. Jo sare unicorn and startups